Good afternoon and welcome to Maths by Gary Maths Tutorials. You can follow us on Twitter at Maths by Gary, and you can also like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. So today we're going to take a look at integration, and we have a list of standard integrals and some examples. So in each case, a is a constant. So first of all, we're going to take a look at the function a. So the function a of any number would become ax. So the integral of a would be ax. An example of this, so if we take the number to be 2, 2 would become 2x and then plus c. So the reason we're doing plus c, because that is the constant of integration, so we add the plus c. Now moving on to the next example, x to the a, now this is when a does not equal minus 1, will become x a plus 1 over a plus 1. So what does that mean? Well, x squared, so we have x squared, so a is 2, so 2 plus 1, so it's going to become x cubed, and then all over a plus 1, 2 plus 1, which is 3, so x squared becomes x cubed plus c, or you could also write this 1 third x cubed plus c, both would be correct. Okay, moving on to the next function, 1 over ax plus b. So the integral of 1 over ax plus b would be 1 over a ln ax plus b. So the example we have is 1 over 2x plus 3. So 1 over a, so we start off 1 over 2 because a is 2. And then ln, it's ax plus b. So that's simply 2x plus 3, because that's what we have here, 2x plus 3, and then the constant of integration plus c. Moving on to the next one, e to the ax becomes 1 over a to the x. So e to the 3x will simply become 1 over 3e to the 3x, and then again plus the constant. Moving on again, ln ax will become x ln ax minus 1. So again, we're just following the rules. So the function, the rule, the example, and the solution. So this will now become, first of all, x, just remember your brackets, ln, so that's ax, so it'll be 2x minus 1, and then the constant of integration plus c. So that's us done 1, 2, 3, 4, that's us done the first 5. So some of these are common, some of them you may have seen, some of them may be new to you, but this is just some basic examples I'm just running through. So we now move on to sine a of x. So we want to integrate sine a of x. So the integral sine a of x becomes minus 1 over a cos a of x. So the sine changes to cos, and it's then just remember the negatives in there as well. So that will become minus 1 over 3. Remember the 3 is because it's 3x, so it's ax, a is 3. So minus 1 over 3, and then cos 3 of x, and then plus constant c. Cos a of x becomes 1 over a sine ax, so cos 4x will become 1 over 4 sine 4 of x plus the constant. And then tan a of x becomes minus 1 over a ln cos ax. So tan 2x will become minus 1 over 2 ln cos 2x plus c. Two more left to do. Sec squared ax becomes 1 over a tan ax, so sec squared 2x will become 1 over 2 tan 2x plus c. And then lastly, cosec squared ax becomes minus 1 over a cot ax, so cosec squared 5x will become minus 1 over 5 cot 5x plus c. So what we've done is we've ran through the function, the rule for integration, so what the function becomes, the integral, the example, and then the solution. So I hope you found this short video of some use, and we will be looking at differentiation and integration, some rules, in further tutorial videos. And remember, you can follow us on Twitter at MathsByGary. Thank you very much, and have a good day.